Even in this place, NCO. And no. Your actions have carried strength. If you speak for the two-headed bear, I'll hear your words, even if I will be the only one to hear them. If you believe it should not die this day, then answer me why. History has proven this, our history, and you think that you have this strength enough for all of NCR. The West is not the divide, and nothing you can do can prevent the missile's launch. Convincing me changes nothing. It may be that as much destruction has been written in the earth here, you may build something else, as you built the divide. You have spoken truly. There is a shadow of a nation behind you, the hope of a people. Yet it may not matter. The divide still stands against us. Our enemies gather outside. Shadows of the bear and a bull. They will have found their way in, just as you did. It was always my intention. In case I could not kill you, the marked men would flood this place, cut off your escape. If we cannot prevent what comes, then let us make our stand here. Two couriers together at the divide.
Experiment log 369248/A.
Hopeville burned, lightless in the night, invisible fires of radiation scorching it from within and without. It is said a man still walked its streets with a tattered jacket, an old world flag etched on the back. He remained there, perhaps as punishment for the scars he left on the wastes, or a reminder of a history he could not forget. For Ulysses, his journey was over. The courier had been the end of his road. As for the courier, she turned her back on her home for the second time and made her way back, navigating the treachery of the divide. Tunnelers and the marked men avoided the lone figure, as if recognizing the courier's right to passage, or out of fear. The courier walked until she stood again upon the edge of the divide, the last road she would walk before the second battle for Hoover Dam. There, beside her feet, was a final package from one courier to another, a footlocker bearing a gift and a message. But that message, it is something for couriers to carry, and for them alone. The lights flickered across the divide, reminders that the old world histories persist and find meaning in the present. It said, war, war never changes. Women do, through the roads they walk. And this road has reached its end.
Last tape, last message. In case you best me, if you're hearing this, you have, through blood or word, this message and all that lies with it. It is for you, courier. If you want to know the why of things, this world, I've walked a good part of it. I stopped only because of you. What you did gave me pause. Long ago, I crossed the Colorado, the first among the Legion to see Hoover Dam in all its glory, an old world wall, yet bridging two sides. And beyond it, a symbol of a two-headed bear, an idea great enough to challenge Caesar himself. Might kill him taking it, whether he won or lost. The bull needs to fight, needs the challenge. Without it, it falters, dies in the dust. Might be a lesson there, in you and me. Leave the thought behind the message to you. My message is this. The destruction that has been wrought at the Divide, or elsewhere, if you couldn't stop me, it can happen again. It will keep happening. If war doesn't change, men must change. And so must their symbol.